Everybody, last weekend, Casey Kane snapped a three-year winless streak, and he couldn't have picked a better time or place in which to do it.
Two laps to decide who will win. It's Brad Kiss last year on the outside to his inside. Casey Kane, side by side across the yard line. Casey Kane will be the winner of the 2017 Brickyard 400.
And by virtue of that win, and that trend could continue this afternoon, but right now we want to welcome in the Brickyard 400 champion, Casey Kane. Casey, first of all, congratulations once again. And just how different is a week for a driver after having a win, especially one as big as a Brickyard?
Yeah, it's been a great week, you know, from visiting with the team guys, the guys at the shop that put a lot of effort in and haven't had wins in a while, you know, on the 524 side, to doing media and things that I hadn't done in a while. So, yeah, it was a cool week, had a lot of fun. It was nice to kind of have that extra boost from winning a cup race, and let alone the Brickyard 400, which is a race that... It's really the race I always wanted to win since I, you know, first started watching races at Indianapolis.
Hey, Casey, I mean, you know, people assume with the win that the pressure is finally off. But as race car drivers, we know the pressure isn't really ever off, is it? I mean, can you kind of explain, you know, what it was like prior to that win and what you know, moving forward, there's still a ton of pressure on a driver.
Yeah, I mean, I think prior, there's always these so much talk going on and different things. Like, I just don't want it anymore. I'm not into it. And but that was far from the case. So, you know, I didn't have as much of that this week. It's just more about, you know, now it's about, you know, winning again, running up front, being as prepared as we can for the playoffs, you know, making the playoffs, getting into that point. So we're still not all the way in there. But, yeah, I mean, there's still a lot that we want to do, a lot that I want to do each and every week. And it comes from preparation, working together, and having faith in each other. And, you know, hopefully that win will give us all more confidence in what we're doing and also what each one of us is doing together.
Yeah, Casey, I mean, this win changes a lot for you and that five team. Number one, you touched on it. You were in the playoffs in 2017. But I heard you talking a little bit in the media center yesterday. Does this change your mindset and your team's mindset and approach to these next six races before the playoff? You're sitting right now only with five playoff points to start the playoffs.
Yeah, it has to a little bit because we need to look at playoff points. We need to look at, you know, starting with more when we get there. But to me, still the biggest thing is just understanding, you know, the speed of the car. And last week we unloaded at Indianapolis. We were second in first practice, I think eighth and second. You know, I felt good. Car had good speed, and understanding why that was. This week we were seventh when we started yesterday. So, yeah, I think there's a lot of little things that we need to do better as a team and better together, and just keep building on that. You know, for the playoffs, and it's tough to win these races. I just saw there's nine straight, you know, different winners in the last nine races. So. It felt great to win, but it's not easy. So we just have to keep working hard and try to build our team to where we have speed every week, put ourselves in position, and, you know, the points will come.
Brickyard 400 champion Casey Kane, thanks for your time this morning, and best of luck going forward, especially in the playoffs.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Still, here's our Connect Live debate. We want you to weigh in. We want to know where you think Casey Kane will be next year. Head to foxsports.com/vote to play along at home. Still to